This place is great, really comfortable. I'm just gonna get settled in. Time to move on. Get on with my life. Yes, absolutely. Said it was a long time ago. Let it go, seriously. Definitely more my style than Panama, or Hoboken, I guess. No, if I'm honest, I just got kind of bored of boozing. I mean, once in a while, but not all the time. You're right, it wasn't doing me any favors. Maybe I'd lost my self-respect, but it's back. I'm excited, really. I really needed a new start. I think you're right. I think I am gonna like it here. It certainly ain't New Jersey. It's my new life. Just like you said. Listen, if you think I can still do a job, what have I got to lose? Apart from the weight. Very funny, ha ha. Yes, that is a fake laugh, you jerk. So I guess I'd become what they wanted me to be. A killer. Some rent-a-clown with a gun who puts holes in other bad guys. Well, that's what they had paid for, so in the end, that's what they got. Say what you want about Americans, but we understand capitalism. You buy yourself a product and you get what you pay for. and these chumps had paid for some angry gringo without the sensibilities to know right from wrong. Here I was, about to execute this poor bastard like some dime store angel of death, and I realized they were correct. I wouldn't know right from wrong if one of them was helping the poor and the other was banging my sister. I'd arrived in Sao Paulo a few weeks before. I was working a protection detail for the kind of people who need protection in a town like this. And what kind of town was this? One where I didn't speak the language and they didn't water down their drinks. So for now, we seemed to get along just fine. Of course, that was about to change.
Hey, brother.
Hey.
How's the cocktail?
Scotch. I never mix my drinks.
Yeah, at least not on duty.
Something like that.
Man, that favela is big.
Yep. Nothing like the view of extreme poverty to make a penthouse cocktail party really swing.
I guess they call it trickle-down economics.
That's funny.
It's supposed to be a charity thing. Drink and give money. I don't know. Something for the kids. Hey, listen, man. We better look lively. This place is a nightmare. Just got cowboys running security downstairs. Something rotten in the air.
That didn't mean much. There was always something rotten in the air. The family we were protecting were local celebrities, rich parasites with delusions of humanity. The kind of people who end up in glossy magazines or body bags, depending on how their luck runs.
So where are they all? I see Rodrigo over there talking to that guy.
Yeah, I don't know him. That guy next to him, he's some kind of cop. I'm not sure. Serious, though. Big end cop, anti-gang sort of thing. I can't remember his name.
So who's this guy?
That guy's a plastic surgeon or some kind of surgeon. Tummy tucks and cock implants. Ha! Look at Marcel. Still dances like a fool.
Guess that's what a European education and a coke habit will do for Ricky Martin look alike.
It's very funny, Max. Oh, excuse me.
I was mostly working for Rodrigo Branco, a local businessman. Built things, did some charity, had things named after him, won awards, owned things, people. One of the trophies he had won was his wife, Fabiana. She was hot and wanted to be dangerous. Some good genes trying to fight their way out of a cesspit. She'd married well and was now at leisure to regret her good fortune. They got along as well as any rich workaholic and his younger airhead wife tend to get along. They mostly ignored each other. She spent a lot of time with his cokehead younger brother, Marcello. He was a good time guy if your idea of a good time was an expensive suit, a bottle of champagne, and nothing between the ears. The middle brother, Victor, had just walked in. He was a local politician. Guy was smoother than an oil slick on an iceberg and about as toxic. The rest of the crowd, I didn't know, but I could imagine the types. People who know if they drink enough, they won't have to feel guilty about their good fortune. Suddenly, things turned real ugly. Felt like our hangovers arrived right on cue. Things had gone from fine to fucked up in about a second, and now there were two idiots at the wheel.
Clear! Got this floor?
Sure.
Look after yourself, bro. Stay safe.
It wasn't my own safety I was concerned about, trophy wife or not. I'd said I would protect the girl. I hoped I hadn't lost my edge, along with everything else. It was time to choose, a nasty fall or a bullet to the head.
Ah,
That was the boss lady. Only this time she wasn't calling for more liquor in her cocktail. She was out on one of the balconies, and I hoped, not about to be thrown off it.
Don't be stupid! Let her go! Come on!
It might have been stupidity, or drunkenness, or maybe both. But before I knew it, I was back taking insane risks, trying to save fallen women.
Nice work. Hey, you need a hand?
No, you. Where the hell's Rodrigo?
I don't know, man. Thanks.
Somebody's gotta go find him.
Está tudo sob controle agora. Fica tranquilo.
I imagined the elevator doors opening to a firing squad of muzzles. As far as I could see it, the one thing my plan had going was that no one else would be stupid enough to pull this move.
Where's Bronco?
Once Bronco was out the door, all bets were off. I had to keep moving. I had to move quick, or Bronco's next charitable donation would be to the worms. It looked like they were taking him out through the basement. Maybe I still had a shot. Rodrigo was too rich a prize for them to throw away. Sure, I'd have to work hard to get him back, but I knew the bad guys would want the boss alive, almost as much as I did.
Control box was on the wall to the left of the gate. Being famous as well as rich is the bad guys know who to kidnap. They weren't waiting on my say-so. I had to move. Another parking lot rattling with gunfire. Was I too late? Rodrigo was in the van. Maybe it was time to let him out. You're okay. You're okay.
Yeah.
Come on, get up. Come on, get up. You're okay. Come with me. Just come on. It's okay.
Ei, vocês aí! Que porra vocês estão fazendo? A justiça local?
Que porra você acha que é falando com meus homens assim?
Você acha que tem o direito de matar as pessoas a sangue frio, Becker?
Cala a boca, cuzão! Continua dando multas. Não põe o nariz onde não é chamado. Vamos!
Ajuda, cara!
Chama uma ambulância!
Fuck.
You did good, Max.
You say so. Don't look so good.
Hey, what could be better, huh? The good guys are reunited, and the Commando Sombra are dead.
I guess. So who's this guy?
I don't know. Some kind of cop. Different branch of the police. Not UFE, but normal cops. I don't know about this stuff. Politics. Everywhere politics. Shit, Max, you look kind of beat up. Let's get this lot home, and then I'll get you home too. Come on.
Back home, it was time for some R&R, the only way I knew how.
Thank you.
And with that, I guess I was ready for bed. Days later, it was back to work, ferrying the boss's broad and his dipshit of a brother out for the night so they could recover from their brush with mortality. Then again, what did I expect? These were the kind of people who went to nightclubs in helicopters. Fabiana had brought her sister along, presumably so she could show off just how rich and empty her life was. And boy, was she about to learn the meaning of rich and empty.
Max! Max! I was speaking to you!
Sorry, what was that?
Oh, I was saying we get into a lot of scrapes, man.
Well, we're still here.
Hey!
Thanks to you, Max. I owe you my life.
Boom. It wasn't just him, huh, baby?
Oh, yes, Marcel. I'm sure you did a lot to save everyone. You were probably worried about getting blood on your stash.
Very funny.
Thank you, Max. I don't know what I would do without my sister.
Spend even more time doing something useful.
You know she works in the favela.
She's the good sister.
Oh, shut up.
What did you hear, Faba? More bodies turned up where people went missing. But it's horrifying.
Did someone say Buzz Q?
Hey.
I'm just kidding, but it is a cool town, man. Hey, here we are. Saúde.
Hello.
I love this view. It's a real chill place to hang, you know? Do a little business, have some fun. I need it too. I've been working far too hard. Like a whore during Fleet Week, as my roommate used to say. You like that, Max?
That's pretty funny. This kind of place made me want to puke. I needed a real drink to deal with the electronic music and the robotic people.
Fucking monkey from a fucking slum. He acts cool with me.
What's that?
Nothing. Say, Max, you're a man of the world. What do you fucking do it, man?
About what? What do you do about life?
Look at me, I'm standing in a nightclub, listening to music I can't stand. I'm 5,000 miles from home, I'm armed and I'm drinking. You don't want to listen to advice from me, amigo.
Oh, Max, I love you, man. You're fucking real, you know? Oh, shit, people. Fuck them, people get me wrong. I think I love a wrong woman. Fabio! Fabio! Ah, my nigga, how are you?
Thank God he has left. A minute more of his drivel and I would have had to put a bullet in him myself. It soon turned out I wasn't the only one. Surprise. It's hard to keep your eye on the ball through the bottom of a glass.